Hey guys, welcome back to Cobra Kai Talk, and today we have the last part of my Cobra Kai Season 4 trailer breakdown. It cuts to Daniel in his house dojo, and he looks very angry. And I'm curious if he'll be able to escape the darkness of Cobra Kai now that Terry Silver is back. And if he's going to use anger to defeat Terry and Kreese, or is he just going to be able to stay balanced and follow Mr. Miyagi's teachings and stick to those. Then we see Daniel and the Miyagi-Do students in Miyagi-Do, and notice that none of the Eagle Fang students are there. So this is probably after the breakup between the two dojos, and we see the kids doing some moves. I think this is going to be right before the Owl Valley tournament, like a few days before, because they're all in their gis, they have their gis, and they look ready to fight. It then cuts to Miguel, who's doing jumping jacks with chains. So we know he's getting ready for the All Valley. We can also see that there is a huge Eagle Fang banner behind him. So we know Johnny is going to turn this place into his dojo. Then we see Tori sparring with who I believe is Robbie because some pictures we got a little bit ago. And we see some of the Cobra Kai students and they're a little surprised because I think Tori is the first one to take down Robbie. Then we see Robbie in the corner store, and he says to Daniel, "Everyone thinks their way is the only way. You, my dad, Cobra Kai, but the truth is, it doesn't matter which way you fight as long as it works." And we could tell by Daniel's clothes, this is the same scene when Daniel was talking to Terry Silver in that store. So that's going to be interesting. In the next scene, we see Daniel and Dimitri getting ready to either spar or do some training on the platform we saw earlier. And we can see there is a sound mixer and a huge speaker, so I think Daniel is taking after Johnny and maybe playing some music to hype up the students a little more. Then we see Johnny in the warehouse we saw earlier, and he's training his Eagle Fang students. Then we see Robbie, Kyler, and another Cobra Kai student. And Kyler and the other student look like they are both fighting Robbie. And we could see that Robbie's kicking their butts. We could tell that this is probably going to be the first episode because of the clothes that Kyler and everybody else is wearing in that scene. Then we see Daniel at Mr. Miyagi's grave. And I've been waiting for this scene to happen again ever since we saw it in season 1. I think this is going to be near the end of the season or near the middle. And he's going there because he's getting angry and letting anger take him over. And he needs Mr. Miyagi's help to find balance again. Then it cuts to Miguel, Johnny, and Carmen in what I believe is Miguel's apartment. And they're sitting down and they're about to have a talk. I think here they're telling Miguel about their relationship, and I don't know how he's going to react. As we know, he loves Johnny, but I don't know how he'll feel that Johnny is that close with his mom and they're dating. But we know that he'll get over it if he's upset because of he's still with Johnny at the end of the season. Then we see Kenny, and he is walking through the hallway at his school, and people are laughing and making fun of him. I think a video of him getting beat up got out, and he's getting made fun of for it. It cuts to Kenny in the Cobra Kai dojo. And this shot looks sick. Kenny looks so small compared to Kreese and everybody in the dojo. And the way they made this shot look is just so awesome. Then we see a standoff between Cobra Kai and Daniel and Johnny's dojos. This shot is no doubt going to be one of the best scenes in the season and maybe even the show. I'm so excited to see what is said here. Because some of the characters look really upset. We cut to Terry Silver telling the Cobras no fighting till the tournament. Notice Terry is wearing the same outfit he was wearing when he confronts Daniel. And I don't think the rule is going to last long because there can't be a Cobra Kai season without fights. It cuts back to the standoff and we see Tori and Sam. I'm so excited to see this. Notice Tori looks a little sad, so I really want to know what is said here. Over this, we hear Daniel saying, "We'll settle this on the mat." It cuts to Kreese and Terry Bowen and transitions over to Daniel and Johnny at the All-Valley Tournament. Daniel is wearing his Miyagi-Do gi, but Johnny is wearing a brand new Eagle Fang gi, and it looks so cool. The red looks awesome, and I can't wait to see how he, like, what he does to pick this out and everything. And I can't wait to see this scene in the season. We hear the All-Valley board member, Ron, say, "It's time to step into the future. This proposal will revolutionize the tournament." By a show of hands, and we see everyone hold up their hand, and they don't look happy. They look like they don't really like what they are agreeing to. Then the All-Valley member, George, says, "God help us all." What they are agreeing to could be lots of things. One thing, it could be letting Terry Silver sponsor the tournament, because they might need money, and he's the only one is willing to sponsor them, and he's the only way the tournament can go on. Or it could be allowing weapons, because we see a clip of later in the trailer, but I don't really think that is it, because it would make the tournament a little weird, and I don't think they would change the tournament up like that. Then we see Robbie do this awesome backflip in his Cobra Kai gi on the All-Valley mat. We could see it's still the blue and gold with the blue mat with the gold fist. Then we cut to Daryl, I think that's his name, saying, "Welcome to the 51st All-Valley Under 18 Karate Tournament." And notice the building in general. It looks a lot nicer than we saw last time. It doesn't really look like the All-Valley Sports Arena. It looks like it's like a brand new building. There's like a Jumbotron type thing. It's like a big TV. And it looks like they got some money. And I'm curious how they got that. Maybe from Terry Silver, like I said before. In the next shot, we see Samantha. And she has two sais in her hands. I don't think this is a fight, because just like the way, like what she's doing. But I think that this is her introduction to the tournament. If you look in the back, we could see Johnny and his Eagle Fang students. We see our first look at the new character, Devin. And now we officially know that she is going to join Eagle Fang. So that gives every dojo at least one girl in it. For our last shot, we see Miguel doing this awesome kickflip. And this is one of the coolest things I've ever seen in the show. I love how he had his comeback in season 3. And I can't wait to see his recovery progress and to see him actually fight in the All-Valley Tournament in Season 4. But yeah, this trailer is everything I could have asked for. And this trailer has gotten me more excited for the season, which I didn't think was that possible because I was already so excited. But this season is going to be insane. But yeah, that's it for my Cobra Kai Season 4 trailer breakdown. My next video will probably be some theories or some, like, I don't know, just talking about some clips or some season stuff. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and remember, strike first, strike hard, no mercy. See ya.